Hey there, in this video I'm going to talk about what is GLBP, that is Gateway Load Balancing Protocol, and we will implement the GLBP in the GNS3. So in my previous video actually I talked about HSRP, that is Hot Standby Routing Protocol, and it was actually providing first hop redundancy, but there was a disadvantage with the HSRP. That is, let's say that R1 is my active router and R2 is my standby router. When you see that R2 is doing nothing, it is just sitting idle, and it has to wait for the active router to fail, and then it will take over and it will be the active router. Well, we don't want it. We want to take the most out of this R2, and we want to take the advantage of this R2, and that's where GLBP comes into play. So GLBP is a Cisco proprietary FHRP, that is first hop redundancy protocol, and GLBP performs a similar function as HSRP, but actually GLBP provides load balancing over multiple routers or gateways using a single virtual IP address and using multiple virtual MAC addresses, and we will understand this, okay? So in a GLBP we have AVG, that is active virtual gateway, and we have AVF, that is active virtual forwarder. Now before explaining AVG and AVF, remember that in a single GLBP group we can have maximum of 4 AVF, and in a single GLBP group there can only be 1 AVG. So what is AVG? Well, remember that the members of a GLBP group will elect one gateway as the active virtual gateway, AVG. AVG for that group, and what does that AVG will do? This AVG will assign virtual MAC addresses to each and every member of the GLBP group. Well, remember, let's say in my case I have 3 routers that are part of a single GLBP group. That is this router, this router, and this router. So this is the AVG as well as AVF. So this will assign the MAC address to this AVF as well, virtual MAC address, and this will assign the virtual MAC address to this AVF as well, and so on. Okay, so this is the AVG. The second job of the AVG is that it will respond to the op requests that are sent by the host, or that are sent for the virtual IP address, and we will understand this later. Okay, then AVF is the one that will forward traffic, and in a single GLBP group all devices including AVG will become AVF. There will be only one virtual IP address, but every router within a GLBP group will have its own virtual MAC address. Like this AVF has its own virtual MAC address, this one has its own virtual MAC address, but the virtual IP address will be the same, right? So remember this, the AVG will also be the AVF as well, okay? And also the router with the highest priority will become AVG. If the routers have the same priority, the router with the higher IP address would be elected to become the AVG. And let's say that I want this R1 to be the AVG, which means that I will set the priority of this router the highest of the all, so that it will become the AVG. But in case if the priority of all the routers were same, then the one with the highest IP address will be the AVG, okay? So now let us talk about that, how does GLBP achieve load balancing? So let's say this PC1 wants to get out of this subnet, then it will send the op request, and you know that this AVG basically will handle op request, and when it receives the op request it will respond with the one of the virtual MAC address of the AVF. Let's say that because we know that the AVG is also the AVF, so let's say that it responds with its own MAC address, that is 1.1.1.1, which means that PC1 will use R1 as its gateway this time. Now let's say that PC2 also wants to get out of this subnet, the PC2 will send the op request, and also you know that the AVG will respond to that op request, so the AVG will respond with the virtual MAC address of AVF. Let's say this time the AVG responds with the virtual MAC address of this AVF, that is 2.2.2.2, which means that the PC2 will use this AVF as its gateway this time, and it will forward the traffic to this R2. Now let's say that PC3 also wants to get out of this subnet, so again it will send the op request, and the AVG will respond with the virtual MAC address, and let's say this time it responds with the virtual MAC address of the R3, that is this one. And it means that PC3 will use R3 as a gateway this time. So this is how load balancing is achieved, and this kind of load balancing is called round robin load balancing, which means that the AVG will respond for the first time with the which will make it a first AVF like in our case R1, and then it will respond, and when it receives the next op request, it will respond with the virtual matrix of the next AVF, let's say in this case it was R2, and when it receives the next op request, it will respond with the virtual matrix of the next AVF, let's say in output it was R3, and so on. So this is how load balancing is achieved. So now let us configure GLBP. So consider this topology, and one more thing, that the connectivity between all devices is preset, and we just need to configure GLBP. So R1 will be my AVG as well as it's the AVF as well. R2 is the AVF, and R3 is the AVF as well. So go to R1 and configure the GLBP. R1, it is conf t interface fast ethernet 5/0. That is this interface, right? 5/0, and then GLBP 10 IP 192.168.10.150. And remember that this is the virtual IP address, which means that the host, which means the PCs, will use this IP address as their gateway IP address. Okay, so enter. As we know that we want to R1 to be the AVG, let us give is the highest priority. So set its priority GLBP 10 priority. Let's say I want to make it 150. Okay, because by default the priority is 100, and it will be the highest priority of all. Okay, now let's enable the preemption as well. That is preempt. So what this preemption will do, that it means that whenever the router with the highest priority comes online, that will be chosen as the AVG. Okay, and that's it. So we have configured on this R1. Let's go to R2 and let us configure a GLBP on R2 as well. So the interface fastnet 5/0 and GLBP 10 IP 192.168. 10.150, that is virtual IP address, and preemption. Let's enable preemption as well. 10 preempt, and there is no need to change the priority because we know that by default the priority is 100. Well, that's it. Okay, configure the R3 as well, and let's go to this interface F2/0. So T conf T interface pass ethernet 2/0 and GLBP. And 10 IP 192.168.10.150, and then GLBP 10 preempt. And we also do not need to set the priority here as well, because by default it's 100, and that's it. So let us verify GLBP. So show GLBP. Well, you can see that state is active, and virtual IP address is this one. Then we have standby is this one, priority is this 150. Then there are three forwarders. Okay, one is active, forwarder one is this one. It's information on the forwarder one. Then we have forwarder two, and then we have forwarder three, and the preemption is enabled, and these all information are given here. Okay, moreover, you can see that the load balancing is round robin. Okay, now let's go to R2 and verify the GLBP. So show GLBP, and that's it. So set standby and so on. Okay, so it means that the GLBP is configured, and moreover, you can see, you can use this command as well, show GLBP, and then brief. Okay, that boom. So now let us verify GLBP using trace route. Okay, so we want to trace route to this R4 from PC1, then from PC3 to R4, and then from PC2 to R4, and let's see that what actually happens. So let us trace R4, and the IP address we will use is this one, that is 192.168.20.2. Let's go to PC1, trace 20.2. Boom. Go to PC2, press. And now go to PC3 and press. Here you see, press. 192.168. Well, look here. So it means that the packet is forwarded to the 192.168.10.1, which means that this time R1 is used as a gateway because its IP address is 10.1. Go to PC2, that this time the packet has sent to 10.100, which is this one. 10.100 is this one, which is R3. And go to PC3 and look here that the packet is sent to 10.200, which is this one. So, 10.200. This is how load balancing is achieved. So I hope that you have learned so many things, and thanks for watching.